welcome to Sunset Seekers. We are so very honored that you stopped by to check out our video. If you're new to this channel, we do mostly state park campground reviews. So if you're into some good RV content, then you should hit that subscribe button. We think that you'll like what you see on our channel. There are a number of campground reviews in our video library, but that's not all. We also have how-to videos, we have product reviews, and we also have a few RV tours in there as well. So check those out. And once again, thank you so much for stopping by. Now today we are at Mountain Magazine State Park. It's in Arkansas. It's actually at the highest point in the state of Arkansas at 2,753 feet. Now, it's certainly not a very high mountain. However, it is high enough up that it does offer some stunning views, some great overlooks around the mountain. Now, Mountain Magazine State Park is located in the Ozark-St. Francis National Forest. There's only one RV campground, and that is the Cameron Bluff Campground. Now, all of the campsites here in the Cameron Bluff Campground are full hookup. They're not all 50 amp. Some of them just offer 30 amp, but they're all beautiful sites, very nicely wooded. Now, I do want to tell you about the tragic event that occurred just before we arrived here at Mount Magazine State Park. We were originally supposed to be going with my mother and father-in-law. Now, if you've been watching our channel for some time, you've seen glimpses of my father-in-law and my mother-in-law also in some of our videos. Sunset Seekers would not exist were it not for my father-in-law especially. And the reason why is because about 4 years ago, my wife and I started going camping with them in their fifth wheel and staying with them. And we really enjoyed it. We really enjoyed it a lot. And that's when I first thought, you know, this would be great to have a fifth wheel of my own. And one of the very first places that we went with them, we went on several camping trips with them, but one of the first places that we went was right here at this very campground in Mount Magazine State Park. So. It is because of them that we are camping and do have a channel. They were supposed to come with us, but tragically, my father-in-law, as he was preparing for this trip, fell off of a ladder and literally broke his leg. He was tending to his fifth wheel at the time. He was trying to clean off his front cap and just slipped off the ladder and fell. And we just arrived yesterday and we already miss them. We miss them a lot. It is really sad being here without them. We were really looking forward to this. I know both my father-in-law and my mother-in-law were really looking forward to this trip. They've been preparing for it. We had actually set reservations to this state park a year ago. So this has been a trip that's been in the planning stages for quite a while. It's very, 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 very sad not to be able to share this vacation together. But I do want to honor my father-in-law and wish him well. He is in our thoughts and our prayers. It's going to be a long recovery time, but we are praying for him, and he's being very well cared for right now. Now, in light of my father-in-law's tragic accident, he did want me to remind those of you who are our viewers and subscribers the dangers of climbing up on a ladder, and to make sure that your ladder is on good, stable footing, because accidents do happen, as is evidenced with what happened to my father-in-law. It was a pretty bad break. The lower, I guess you would call that, it was just right above his ankle. So that would have been the tibia and fibia bones, I believe. But it broke both bones. It was a pretty bad break. Bad enough to where he is going to need a couple of surgeries and quite a bit of recovery time. So to all of our dear subscribers and our viewers out there, please be careful. If you're outdoors, please make sure that someone knows what you're doing, because my father-in-law was outside for some time before he was discovered by my mother-in-law. So make sure if you're going to climb up on top of your rig or whatever it is that you're doing on a ladder, to let someone know, and that someone is within shouting range. They can hear you if you fall. I'm always very nervous when I climb up on top of my fifth wheel. So I always let Christy know whenever I'm doing some kind of maintenance, whether I'm putting a max air cover on, whatever it is I'm doing, I always let her know. And we want to encourage you to do the same thing for your own safety. Now, as I said before, we did arrive last night. So first things first, we're going to start off our video with giving you a tour around our campsite. It is a pretty level site. You do have a little bit of a drop off here from this slab right down here. But in the campsite here, you do have a very big picnic table. And you've got a lantern hook barbecue grill, and a fire pit. And it's a pretty level area around the fire pit, which I always like that. I cannot stand to have a really sloped spot around the fire pit. Makes it less comfortable for putting out your chairs and everything. Now, back behind the campsite is a very nice level tent pad. So, if you want to bring some guests along or your kids want to camp out behind the campsite, really nice level site there. And as you can see, just beautiful wooded area. Pretty nice space in between the sites. That right there is site number one, and it's quite a distance away. I like the fact also that they have, I don't know if you can see that right there, but that's a little trash can. So you don't have to walk very far to put away your trash. There are black bears in the area, so they are covered. They do have a lock on them. They kind of latch, I should say, when you put the trash in there. So that's a good thing. This particular site is 50 amp, full hookup. As I said before, all of the sites in the Cameron Bluff campground are full hookup.
Now, there is still a lot to see at Mount Magazine State Park, and we have just barely scratched the surface. We don't want this video to be too long, so we'll focus in on giving you a quick look at the RV sites to give you an idea of what to expect when booking a site at the park. There are 18 sites in the Cameron Bluff RV loop. We'll view those sites and then revisit the nearby Cameron Bluff overlook that was shown in our opening sequence. We'll show you what the overlook looks like from the ground, and then we'll head on over to the visitor center. We'll only linger there for a few moments to give you a sneak peek and check out the adjacent nature center. From there, we'll explore some of the trails that you can find at Mount Magazine and tell you a little bit more about our favorite trail. Next, we'll show you one of the awesome cabins for rent and the view that you would see from your own private observation deck near the highest point in the state of Arkansas. Our next stop will take you inside the lodge for a quick tour where we'll visit the Skycrest Restaurant. And finally, we'll end our video with a bird's eye view of the cabins in Mount Magazine Lodge that have stunning views of the Arkansas River Valley below. Now, if you're thinking about booking reservations to Mount Magazine State Park, we think you'll find this to be a very informative video. So stick around, and thanks again for watching.
This is the Cameron Bluff overlook, and it is beautiful. What do you think, babe?
It is beautiful.
Absolutely beautiful. Just got some drone footage here, and you can see for miles around. Very beautiful. And I do like these little stone walkways that they built in here. They've got a little observation deck right here, which is really nice. You got to mind the stairs though, so you don't trip. But I mean, this is awesome. You know, Arkansas may not boast some of the highest peaks in the states. Doesn't have any really tall mountains, but there are. That doesn't mean that there aren't some really picturesque, beautiful views like this. I mean, this is an absolutely gorgeous view. And you can see for miles around here. It's a little hazy today, but there are a few clouds in the sky up there. But there's a little bit of haze out over this way. There's another little observation point down over here. Oh yeah, this is a nice little point over here. Very cool.
They are wild and usually avoid people. Consider yourself lucky to see one. If you do, please report it to the front desk. Here's what they want to know. You're fill out a short form of the details. Date, time, location, number, estimated size, color markings, and activity. Like you're gonna think of all that when you see a bear in the
wild. Yeah, all I'm gonna be doing
you're
is
be like,
screaming.
Wait, what time is it? Oh, date? How big is he?
Yeah.
Where's his markings? So you have a tattoo?
So notes. You're supposed to do all this while you're screaming and running the other way.
Your assistance is appreciated. Oh my word.
Oh well.
You might want to come down here.
This is a way zone down here, yeah.
It is.
Kind of reminds me of Petit Jean.
We've explored the Cameron Bluff RV campground, overlook, and amphitheater, and from there we checked out the visitor center and also toured the nature center. Now we're going to make our way over to the lodge at Mount Magazine, but we'll take a look at a few of the hiking trails before we get there. Oh wow, this is spectacular.
Down there, if you would, baby.
This is okay. This is awesome. This is Inspiration Point, and you see plenty of area here where you know you can just kind of hang out here. In fact, Christy and I are gonna pop out some chairs and just kind of hang out here for a little bit. It's so beautiful. Nice and shaded right here. I've got a couple little backpacking chairs here. They're actually pretty comfortable. And we've laid the chairs out here and we're just sitting here at Inspiration Point, taking in the views and having a little snack, eating some trail mix, drinking some water. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful trail. Probably one of my favorite parts of Mount Magazine State Park.